Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kate, and we're going for another of the ciders. I occasionally like to have a cider. I don't know that much about ciders, so I'm learning, I'm trying, you know. So you have to bear with me if I get stuff wrong. Do forgive me, because I'm trying to learn about the ciders. Getting the old BB Barfly on there again. Great guys down from Canada, absolutely brilliant. But we're gonna go for, and as I said, I've been down to Morrison's, the best vintage cider made from. See that from? Just before we carry on, when you see made with. So and so, blah blah, and picked this, that, and the other, and picked by Virgin's apples and all that business. You know, if it says made with, it doesn't necessarily. It could be juice flown over, like concentrated juice flown over from China or wherever. You know, and virtually solid. You know, and then rehydrated, and then they had. An apple or two in there, you know, an end picked by a virgin apple or two, you know. It doesn't really mean a lot, so you know, beware of reading between the lines, beware of kind of some of these things. It's like if you get food or some you know, any sorts of food, if it says flavour, there's none of it in there. If it says cheese and onion flavour, there's no cheese or onion in there. If it says cheese and onion flavoured, there's a certain amount of it. I say there's none in there. I think they have to have more than 5% or more than 4%. I don't know the exact rules for it to be flavoured, you know. So if you've got salmon flavoured, it's flavoured with it, you know. Like fish flavoured crab sticks. You don't know what's in there. Get on with it, Tel. We're reviewing cider here. Right, it says on there, made from the best quality English cider apples. Matured in oak vats for a full-bodied, fruity flavour. Right, it says, made from the best quality English cider apples, fermented using the best ingredients and then matured in oak vats for up to 6 months. Specially selected for the best, as the very best of the year's vintage. This craft cider has been made using traditional Herefordshire methods. Is that different to other places? I don't know. It kind of like, you go, really? I'm hoping someone's going to kind of enlighten me. Is Herefordshire methods, are they different to making cider everywhere else? I'm hoping someone will enlighten me on that one. It is full-bodied, robust and well-balanced with a long fruity finish. Right, 7.3%, 500ml. It has in most cases, they've got the, what do you call it, sulfites, wherever they are. It's vegetarian, which means that it's not fined with, you know, fish bladders, isinglass and all that business. Crack it open, Till. Look at the bottle cap, look at that, fizzy, listen. Ooh, can you hear that? Leave some in the bowl. Look at that dancing, look at that, that is a party. That is such a lovely, beautiful, look at that. It's lively, isn't it? But look at them little trilling party bubbles. Oh, wow. That is such a beautiful sight. Pinprick bubbles. Lovely little pinprick bubbles. Let's have a sniff. See if I can get some of the things, flavours, on the way up. It smells delicious. Made the hairs on the back of my neck stand up. There's plenty of hairs on the back of my neck at the moment. I need a good shave up. But the hairs on the back of my neck actually stood up because I've been trying to find nothing against any French ciders because, or the French or whatever, because I absolutely adore their ciders. But I'd like to see, you know, one of the Brit boys get in there and kind of, you know, show them all about how it's done. And that's not being me being xenophobic or anything like that. I don't even know what the word means. Yeah, it's got some really lovely aromas. And I don't know what I'm talking about, but it smells almost as if it's not blitzed. It's got that kind of slight tannin smell to it that it smells cracked. The little seeds and pips and things all smell as if they've been cracked in there with it. Anyway, crack on. Let's have a taste. Oh, wow. Oh, did you see the hairs? Woohoo! The hairs, my hairs stand up when I get something like that. That is cracking. There's a slight, strange little flavour in there, which is not nasty. It's a nice flavour. But it's not an apple I've ever come across, you know. Oh, good Lord, that is lovely. You can taste sun-ripe apples with tough little skins on them, and not these so-called pretty French golden delicious. A friend of mine was saying that they're kind of like an American invention. And the French are selling them to us. They won't eat them. We're stupid enough, dumb enough to buy them. Don't, listen, stop buying French golden delicious apples because they're not golden, they're not delicious. And I think it's debatable whether they're French, I don't know. Look at that. That is such a thing of beauty. Look at it, look. Oh, that is so lovely. It's a refreshing, beautiful, smack in the mouth of apples. This has got a bigger apple to it than when Newton discovered gravity. Or you know, discovered it. Did he invent it? He invented gravity. He's a Brit. He invented gravity. But that is absolutely stunning. There's a kind of buttery feel to it. A smoky, sort of smoky back taste that kind of hangs on. There's that tannin of the skin and the kind of the core and stuff. It's a member of the National Association of Cider Makers. Doesn't say who makes it though. Yeah, I wish they'd just put somewhere or other, don't matter where, how small it is, who makes that, because that is wonderful. If anyone knows what apples go in this as well, please let me know, because this is really wonderful. This has been me, Terry K, for Beer Goggles Reviews, enjoying a beautiful cider. Try this one. Right, if you want to find out what a nice cider tastes like, Morrison's the best vintage cider. Try it. absolutely, absolutely worth it. I think it's £1.75 a bottle. So worth it, it's unbelievable. Go and buy it, it's absolutely beautiful. Cheers, thank you very much. Good night and goodbye, thank you.